I walked in and said, I'm visiting. Can you help me out? You helped me. Super nice of you. Thanks. But I'm taking over your place, and I have to ask you to leave. Because my laws and the laws from where I come from say I can do this. I'm not unfair, though. We'll sign an agreement to live in peace. And if you want, I'll give you your own small place within mine. Super nice of me. But you can't leave, or you'll be put in jail. You can ask me to leave, and I'll give you a piece of paper, but the paper is a reward, me doing you a favor. You're welcome. That was just, does anyone have any thoughts about that, or do you think, does that sound like one-sided, or what do you think about that?
Well, I think it's pretty realistic. It'll help them to understand. And for a long time, I taught grade five, and what I would do is I would take them through like a visual process where I turn off the lights, put the door on my head, close the eyes, and I'm talking about a society coming from another planet with all these neat technologies, and at first they look pretty cool, everybody's excited, but eventually they're taking over. So same kind of thing. But I make it pretty long, and they do get emotional. I finally get it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just kind of taking that perspective. Okay.
Is that something that you made up, or is that something you found?
I made it up.
Sure.
No, it's just, you know, like they have a pill that gives you knowledge, you know, but then eventually they can't practice their religion, they can't live with their parents, things like that, and they get angry. Like they feel it, they start to, you know, you see the looks on the face and comments.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Any other thoughts? I like that that has the kind of perspective of like, it's so nice of me to let you live in your land that actually now I'm taking over, and that attitude that I sometimes think they don't quite get, that it was that entitlement that everybody thought coming over.
Yeah, totally. It's just kind of taken for granted.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, oh, you didn't understand that that's what's happening? Oh, that's sad.
Yeah.
Get over it.
But, you know, we knew about the beginning. Didn't you see when we put that flag? You know that flag? Do you know what that meant?
Yeah.
I missed that.
Okay. How are we doing for time here?
A little bit.
I'm still thinking. Yeah, so one of the things we had to do for research for our project was to find a story that is about local history and culture, which I'm from Calgary, and like, if you would ask me about local history, I'd be like, the Stampede! They did stuff and rode horses! And that's about it for that. And so we looked up stories, and one of the ones I found was about Edmonton. So there's a number of bands surrounding Edmonton. So I know you have like Enoch Cree Nation to the west, and you have other ones, which you guys would know better than me. But one of the ones we were looking at was the Papa's Chase Band, which is down by where Mill Woods is right now. And so basically, Papa's Chase was a band that was right by Mill Woods, and Fort Edmonton had set up near the river. And first of all, so you have the Hudson's Bay Company trading, so you give guns for furs, and that's awesome because you can hunt a lot better. You can also give medals and knives, and they're working together. But when they came to do the treaty, they measured the land for the number of people there were, and there were settlers that got mad because they wanted more land, and so they remeasured the land based on a smaller amount of people. And then our lovely Frank Oliver, who was Minister of Interior and Superintendent General of Indian Affairs, he was very vocal and very out there about not having non-white people here, especially.
So super racist, is how I would
say. He was also pretty racist, and he was also a journalist, and so there's a number of settlers that, even though there was this treaty for the land, they would go onto the land and they would cut down the wood and build houses there and stuff, and eventually they lobbied the government hard enough to remove the band from the land, and so they took the people and they moved them all, pretty much all across Alberta. So there's some people up north, some people down south, so you have some by Lethbridge, some by St. Paul, like even up by Fort Mac, and all across there. And then So now there's a number of grandchildren and children that have been trying to at least, if not get compensation for it, to at least be acknowledged for it. But the government set up a number of rules saying you only have 10 years to do it. You have to prove it, so you have to have lineage. And they have a number of other rules. So they've just had a lot of problems with that. And so kind of looking at the history of Edmonton, so of all the settlements and how Edmonton grew and how it amalgamated a number of cities, and then also stories like that where you're like, how do I feel about that? And like, at me as a student, when I hear this, I'm more of the now what